Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In today's video, we will learn Power BI data modeling related question that has been asked in Power BI exam. So the question is, you have Power BI data model that contains three tables, sales, date and product. And there the sales table has relation with date and product table, that is many to one. And then sales table contains one numeric column, that is total sales amount. Now you need to create a measure named total sales that can be used in visuals to aggregate total sales amount by product or by the date. So what we should use? So first let's see the data model in the Power BI. Before we start on the today's question for the creating a calculated measure in the data model, I will ask you one question and you can attempt it by providing answer in comments window. So the question is, you need to create a relationship between two tables named sales and sales detail in a Power BI data model. For every row in the sales table, there is at least one row and possibly multiple in the sales detail. So what kind of the relationship we need to establish? It would be many to many from sales to sales detail, or it would be many to one from sales to sales detail, or it is one to many or one to one. And I will provide the answer at the end of this video. Now we are in Power BI query editor. And here you can see we have three tables, date, sales and product. Under date, we have all the dates along with the date key. Then we have sales table. Under sales table, we have sale ID, product ID and quantity sold and then product rate. And then we have date ID and last we have total sales amount. And thereafter in product table, we have product ID and product name. As per the question, there is a one to many relationship from each of the date and product table to the sales. So now let's try to establish the relationship. So now I'm in Power BI model view and here we have all three tables. Now let's establish the relationship based on the given requirement. So here from product, it is towards the product table. And it should be one to many. So here you can see it's one to many. And similarly from sales table to the dates. And this is also one to many. Now we have data ready. Let's go back to the question. And here it says like we need to create a measure named total sales that can be used into visuals to aggregate total sales amount by product or by date. So to create a measure, we have four options. Here first we have total sales equals to all sales total sales amount. So here if we go with the syntax in all, there is a no sum function applied. And since we are trying to achieve the sum of the total sales, then this function will not work. So let's go to the next option, that is calculate. Again, here we don't see sum at all. It is not going to calculate sum of the total sales. So this will also not work. And the option C, there it's try to calculate the max of the total sales amount, that will also not work. And the final option is the sum, that should work. So now let's try to create a measure using this expression. So here in sales table, let's go to the new measure. And the measure name is the total sales. Then we have to provide the sum of the total sales amount. And that's it. So here we have total sales measure. Now let's go to the report view. And here in a visual, let's add the date key and the product ID. And we need a sum of the sales, that is total sales of these two dimensions. And here you can see we are getting total sales for date as well as the product. Now let's try to remove the product ID for now. And here we can see we are getting total sales for each date. Now instead of date, let's try to add the product. And let's remove the date for now. And here you can see we are getting total sales for each product. Now coming back to the question for the day. Here the question is, we need to establish a relationship from sales to sales detail, where in sales table we can have one row and in sales detail we can have one or more than one records. So it says the relationship would be one to many. So here the answer is option C, that is one to many. If you want to see the practical example of this question and how the one to many relationship has been established, then I will provide you a link in a description window that you can refer for the detailed practical example. This is all for today's video. We'll see you in next video.